Hi, my name is Norman, and I am obsessed with cable management.
Hi, Norman. Please, go ahead.
Okay, so naturally, my desk here in the back did receive a lot of upgrades. So in this video today, we are going to focus on the 3D printed upgrades. The reason is that I think a desk is a very individual space. I mean, it's a workspace and it's optimized for the person working at it, right? Yeah, I think with 3D printing, you can do things which wouldn't be viable to buy because they would be too expensive, or which are just not available to buy. Yeah, I think 3D printing, especially here, is a place to shine. You know, when people ask me, yeah, you have a 3D printer, what are you doing all day? Yeah, I'm cable managing all day. That's what I do with my 3D printer. You know, over the years, 3D printing got very popular, and many people see it as they don't take it serious, you know? They say you can print trinkets and octopuses and that's it. But of course, there's a lot more to it, and here's what you can do. Okay, let's just start here with these headphone hangers, because, well, it is what it is. Boring, and it does nothing more than, you know, hanging headphones, so that one was kind of easy. And the next thing is right here behind my speakers. This is just a little hole I drilled, or a huge hole and a plug to cover the hole and, you know, make a little nicer finished edges. You can actually buy those things, and they're also kind of cheap. But I designed them because I felt like doing so. Also here in the middle behind the screen, there's the same piece, but without the cap. Honestly, just, you know, go buy the finished product. It's probably a little bit better. And yeah, there's no need to print those. I just printed them because I could. All right, now let's talk about the more exciting cap. This one is a single cable cap. I think it's a 12 millimeter hole, so that, you know, the cable here just went through. What I like about this thing is that actually the cap of the cap, it's a compliant mechanism, and one thing, it closes up the hole, and the other thing is, of course, it holds the cable in place and holds it upright so that it looks like, you know what you're doing. And by the way, you can tell I'm very hole in table friendly. That's because, you know, I prefer having a hole here rather than having the cable running all the way back and then through the back of the table. That's just a lot more cleaner look, and it has obvious downsides, but, you know, I can always replace the table top, but cable management is priceless. Also, I got the same type of cable cap here in the back for my USB-C powered microphone. So now let's talk about things on the underside. All right, I'm lying back on the floor. The reason is because I wanted to show you the entire table in one shot, so that you can get a clear view of what's going on under there. Here in the front, we have a drawer, which is, yeah, it's a drawer. We're gonna come back to that later. Here is the, you know, power strip of the two monitor speakers. This one is the motor of the table. Here is the main power strip. You can see it's quite populated, but still a little bit left. Here in the back with the HP logo is a Thunderbolt hub, which I have from my employer. This one is the USB hub, which is the brains of the entire operation, basically. So it's plugged in into the Thunderbolt hub. So basically that thing is actually the brains, right? This one is what I think the power supply of the screen. And this one is the power supply of the Thunderbolt hub, I think. Something like that. This is all the technology under my desk. So now that you know what's going on, let's talk about the management. So you may have already noticed one of those T brackets up here, And I think they're pretty, pretty cool. You want to know why? Let's say the industry standard in the cable management industry, basically, is some kind of cable tray, like the IKEA Signum rack, which is like a wire basket. It's very popular. And I get that. They're good. There's nothing wrong with that, except that they are not low profile. With a desk like this, which is height adjustable, when the cable management is not low profile, it's going to be visible when you're standing further back if the cable is up high. So I actually had a cable basket here on this desk, and I just didn't like it when I was standing up and going, leaving the room for a coffee or something, and I saw all the cables in there and I just didn't like it. So yeah, I designed some T-hooks, single screw, easy to install, and extremely low profile, which is cool. And well, some of you may recognize this thing here. This is actually from the enclosure which I built for the 3D printers. It's the same power strip and the same attachment. I just reused them. So this is the only thing printed out of ASA. The rest is just black PETG because I happen to have a lot of it, and green PETG, obviously. Yeah, I think overall PETG is also a very suitable material for this kind of application, especially the power supplies. They may get hot, or this Thunderbolt dock here. So having a little bit more heat resistance than PLA is probably a good idea. Speaking of green PETG, whoop, up here we have those two power supplies which I was talking about. It's actually incredibly easy to design brackets for power supplies. If you want to know how it's done, just drop a comment down below. Then I'm gonna make a fully fledged tutorial about it, because I think those things are also a very, very good way to actually practice CAD. You're not only learning how to actually, well, draw something and you know, measure real life things. The most important feature which you're gonna learn when designing some kind of brackets like those is that you're actually going to learn how to design for 3D printing. So I'm the guy and my peer who has 3D printers, right? So of course, and there's nothing wrong with that, friends come over and ask, hey Norman, can you print this? And more than often, these things they send me, they're just horribly designed. How am I supposed to print this without a ton of support, right? I think a lot of people neglect design for printability. Yeah, I get it. Often you spend like, 4 hours designing something so that you're able to print it without supports, instead of, you know, taking 20 minutes to remove supports. Long story short, right? Learn how to design for manufacturer. I think that's the technical term for that. So, and well, here in the back, you can see this huge drag chain. It's almost the same principle as these T-brackets here. There is a ready-made industry solution, but I just don't like it for different reasons. I think the ones you can buy for those desks, they look like a movie prop from the Predators movie. And other than that, they take up valuable space on underneath your desk. Yeah, foot space is very important for me. That's why I designed this thing to use a regular drag chain, which you're gonna find in CNC machines and also 3D printers, some of those at least. It's basically just holding one side of the drag chain at the leg and the other side screwed at into the underside of the tabletop. So let me just... Okay, so now when the height of the desk, when the desk is lowered, you can see how the drag chain behaves. It's just, you know, in case you have never seen a drag chain, this is how it looks like. Well, right? And I think it's a lot cleaner and a lot cooler because, you know, I love CNC stuff. So having one of those parts here in my desk is just, makes me happy. So there's one question, right? Why is it so big? Obviously, there are a lot smaller drag chains available, and they would be fine because there's just one cable, like the power cable running from the bottom here up there. And this is the cable which is used on the big power strip. And this one is distributing the power to the rest of the setup, right? So there's only one cable going up here. And the reason is because I plan on getting a subwoofer for those tiny speakers up there. And yeah, that means two cables coming down and two more cables coming up again for the audio signal. And those would be XLR cables, so also huge diameter. So I designed for the future. And I haven't bought a subwoofer yet because honestly, my audio is pretty crap in here. And it's only, you know, add more bass, it's just gonna be worse. So I'm not, nah. So, and the last thing under my desk, for those of you who have been paying attention, they already saw it, it's this thing here. This is like ridiculously over-engineered for what it does. You can tell I have two USB cables coming from my hub into the drawer. One is actually my company phone, because, well, they gave me a phone, but I'm basically just using it for two-factor authentication. So it's inside my drawer and it's always charging. And the other cable is just a USB extension cord. Yeah, it's just so that I have a little USB cable coming out in the drawer here. This thing, it has ball bearings and everything. It's there to prevent the cable from hanging down here. It's forcing a horizontal zigzag instead of a vertical zigzag. So that, you know, as always, when you're looking from the front, cables are low profile. And when we neglect the fact that this keyboard here is also fully 3D printed and designed by me, link in the description, this is the last upgrade I made. I think this is also pretty, pretty cool. You guys know what it is, maybe, maybe not. It's a trend in all those setups lately, or for the last year probably. It's basically a lamp. That's it. It's a lamp. And the best thing about it is you can tell by just looking at it, it gives a lot of light without actually blinding you. Like this is the regular position, seating position height. Looking down, no blinding lights. You need to be actually a lot lower to have the lamp blinding you. So that's a pretty cool thing. What makes this mount so special, right, besides being 3D printed, is because it also accepts a webcam down below. Before, I... yeah, this is the home office dilemma, right? You need a webcam nowadays. And I used to stack them both on top, and it was very annoying because I need to be worried about toppling over when, you know, turning it on and off, and also when cleaning and all that. So this was kind of... yeah, it was annoying me every single day, basically. So I designed a bracket, which is replacing the original bracket of the light bar. So this is gonna avoid, obviously, everything they give you with this light bar. And also, of course, down below here, I can actually screw down the webcam. And the entire fixture holds on the back of my monitor stand. The reason is because I didn't like the little feet, which you usually have in the front of the screen. So now it's basically floating above the screen. It's awesome. Unfortunately, I would publish designs like those, but honestly, this is very individual. I mean, I need someone who buys the exact same light strip with the exact same monitor arm and the exact same camera, and probably also prefers the exact same height of the monitor. Yeah, that's not gonna work, right? So unfortunately, those individual pieces, makes no sense to publish them. But for the rest, you're gonna find all of those in the description. I don't know what this guy is saying. I think I'm just gonna upload everything. And then if it doesn't work, that's your problem. So, and that being said, this is my desk and all those upgrades I made for over the last year. Yeah, I hope I could, give you some ideas to borrow. Yeah, this video here is also sort of, you know, intended as a kumbaya style video where everybody is sharing what they know and what they learned over their cable management career. So if you have any ideas how to make things better, even in this setup, or, you know, just found some really, really cool cable management files, which are well designed for manufacturer. You can just post them down below, please. I'm very curious what the internet is gonna bring. You know, help each other out, because in times like those where everybody is in home office basically, it's more important than ever, right? And to me, it was before, even before it was very important, honestly. Anyway, if you enjoyed it and if you learned something new, I'm happy. So, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.